All right, I got something really fun planned today. I'm going to show you how to use generative AI like ChatGPT to create presentations from scratch. Now, before I do, I want you to remember this one thing. AI can do amazing things, as you're about to see, but you, as the human being using AI, must always remain in the driver's seat. With that in mind, let's do this. I'm going to share my screen, and hopefully, you can see what I want you to see, which is these two windows. All right, perfect. So on the left-hand side, we have ChatGPT I'm going to use for this live demo. On the right-hand side, I'll explain in a little bit. This is my code editor. I'm going to use ChatGPT to create a presentation from nothing, which means I don't have to think of what to put in these slides. I don't have to create the slides at all. ChatGPT can do it all for me. And I'm going to use this right-hand side code editor to display the slides I create. All right, so this is the story we're going to work with. And again, this is a live demo. I have no idea what's going to happen in ChatGPT, which makes it really fun for all of you watching and terrifying for me as a presenter. But let's do this. All right. So this is the story I'm going to be working with. Act as the manager in a jewelry company called Diamonds Forever, fictitious jewelry company. Your team created an AI that the company uses to identify fake versus real diamonds, real use case that exists in the real world. An investigation revealed that the AI started making poorer predictions after an update last quarter when it received a batch of training data from a new vendor. Specifically, last quarter, it identified 10% of diamonds as fake, which is higher than the quarterly average of 1%. So dramatic increase, significant anomaly. You are concerned, as this manager in the jewelry company, you are concerned that the model has been making inaccurate predictions and customers are buying fake diamonds they are not aware of. Your task is to communicate to the CEO of this company in a slide deck with three slides, what's going on? Arbitrary designation, it changes to however you want. This is just what I'm going to use to keep this presentation simple. Okay. Provide all the details for what should go on each slide. All right. With this prompt, let's see what ChatGPT gives me. And just to outline what I've done in this prompt, I've not just said to ChatGPT, please give me a presentation that talks about this anomaly in diamonds, I'm telling it, the human aspect, who I am, who I'm presenting to. So it can give me a bit more of a personalized, customized response. So let's see what it gave me. All right, three slides as requested. Title slide, company logo, presentation date, the problem that we're experiencing, fantastic. Quarterly average, 1%. Last quarter was 10%. And an action plan, what do we have to do next after this? Great. What you'd normally do from this point is just copy this, paste it into Google Slides, PowerPoint, whatever tool you use. But I'm going to blow your mind a little more and show you, you don't have to do any of that anymore. There's a cool tool called MARP, M-A-R-P. And MARP uses a type of code called Markdown, which developers, analysts, scientists use to create reports, documentation, even slides. And the principle of MARP is everything in a slide deck is code. The fonts, the colors, the text itself, it's all code. And if it's code, AI can write that code for you. So on the right-hand side, you have my code editor. I'm going to ask ChatGPT to write me the code for this slide deck so I can then visualize it in this code editor and then print it. So let's do that. ChatGPT, generate a single markdown code block for a slide deck where MARP is set to true in the front matter based on the outline you created. So what that means is, ChatGPT, I want to create markdown code, set the MARP attribute to true at the very beginning in the front matter. And that's what the MARP ecosystem expects to create a slide deck. Let's do it. Instantly, ChatGPT gives me this beautiful code block, everything I need. Defining the headlines of the slides, the bullet points, all I need to do so simply is copy this, paste it here in my code editor, Visual Studio Code, and you can see on the right-hand side, because I've installed the plugin for MARP into Visual Studio Code's environment, every slide that it wants me to create. So I have the title slide, identifying the problem, mitigating the issues, additional notes. This is fantastic. You can imagine, I used to spend hours, if not days, if not weeks, creating presentations before. I'm sure the same has been true of you. Look at what ChatGPT is able to do within seconds. But the real question is this good? And it's my responsibility as a presentation trainer to tell you, these slides ChatGPT created suck. Why? Look at all the text present on the slides, especially in this slide number 2, identifying AI performance decline, or 3, mitigating performance issues. It would take someone at least a minute, if not 2, to read through all of that text. And a presentation is not about dumping information on people that they could easily read on their own time, but giving them a good experience, a simple guided experience of that information so they can see what they can do about it. Making people read slides is a tedious, poor experience. So let's go back to ChatGPT. Me as the human being, as the human expert, going back in and telling it how to give me a better output. So I'm going to tell ChatGPT explicitly, update the MARP markdown code block to make each slide more concise. Be sure of the following details. So this is what I always recommend for prompting. You specify exactly what you want. The more details you provide, the better ChatGPT can do in giving you your expected output. Slides are delimited by this. That's just MARP notation, how it indicates slides. Each slide has only one heading 1. So just one headline. I don't need a lot on each slide. Each slide has only 3 list items or less of text below heading 1. Remove list items if there are more than 3. This is arbitrary. I'm just saying each slide should only have 3 bullets, no more. That's it, the maximum. If you have more than that, please remove it. You can change this to whatever you'd like. Be sure there are 3 slides total. Okay, let's see what this does. So it'll give me an updated code block, which hopefully addresses everything that I want. And you can already see in the code, it's limited the text to the 3 bullet points I asked for. Fantastic. So I'm going to just delete all this. Remember what this looked like. It's about to change. And there you go. Simpler, 3 slides, 3 bullet points on each. You could see how I could push this even further, make it even more concise, but this is a great starting point. Now, my opinion as a presentation trainer is one thing, but the most important opinion of all when you're presenting is, what is the opinion of your actual audience? Most of the time, we just go into a presentation, we prepare the slides, and we hope and pray that the audience will like it. Not anymore. With ChatGPT, you can have it pretend to be your audience, your human audience, and give you the feedback they never would give you. So you can come in super prepared for that presentation. Let me show you how that's done. This is the really fun part of ChatGPT, the human element of it. Act as the CEO of the company Diamonds Forever. So before I asked it to pretend to be me and create the slide deck, now I'm saying, please pretend to be my audience and evaluate the slide deck you just created. I'm gonna, for more detail, remember the more detail you give ChatGPT, the better output it can provide, give some personality traits to the CEO, his tendencies, her tendencies to criticize, to see information in a certain light, perspective, perhaps they're non-technical. And using all those attributes, it can give me an appropriate response this CEO would give. So act as the CEO of this company, Diamonds Forever. You have been in this position for a long time and used to the current way of working. Let's make up some stuff. You are very busy and short on time and only want to hear you're doing a good job. And let's add in that extra wrinkle. You are also non-technical and understand nothing about AI and algorithms. So this is important. If you're talking to a specific audience, you need to be aware of what they do understand and what they don't, so you can tailor the content accordingly. So let's define this audience like that. Then your task is broken down into 2 steps. What I also recommend for prompting, don't ask it to do everything at once. Break it down so you can see its output at each step. First, evaluate the slide deck you created previously. Critique it harshly by discussing how it falls short and offer tailored, actionable advice. And step 2, update the text in the markdown code to address all the critiques and implement all the actionable advice. All right, take your time. and do this step by step. Fantastic. Here we go, ChatGPT. All right, this is my favorite part because you get to see the actual critiques an audience of this caliber would give you, but just perhaps be too polite to say, or they actually give it to you on the presentation day and you ideally like to know it beforehand. So let's see. Evaluation of the slide deck. Well-structured, clear overview, but it's a bit complex. It may be too technical for someone who doesn't understand AI and algorithms. It's a bit too long, may overwhelm the CEO. Fair point. You want to identify the problem, but also propose solutions. All right. So let's see what it did. Remember what this looks like, because it's about to change. All right. So here we have the simplified slide deck. And let's see. It looks like we've changed some of the wording to make it less technical. We've reduced some of the bullet points to make it less verbose. And it's already in much better shape than it was before because I identified my audience and I identified what actionable steps we can take to fit their needs. All right, beautiful. Now this gave you a little teaser of what generative AI like ChatGPT can do, but you can see how you could push this in any direction you want, make it as fancy as you want, as detailed as you want in any domain of your choice. But no matter what, I want you to remember that one thing. You as the human being using AI must always remain in the driver's seat. You can, for example, have it pretend to be your human audience. Have it give you feedback they can't give you in advance, so you can come prepared with a presentation that best fits their needs. Or you as the human expert need to come in and say, is this a good product? Is it not? You are just having ChatGPT as your assistant do tasks for you. You know how to do yourself. You need to push it in the right direction. I want to close now with this parting thought. In the next few years, it's believed AI will make the world a much more cold, machine-like, automated place. But I hope in this presentation today, you've seen it couldn't be farther from the truth. If used in the right way, AI can make us more human by teaching us how to present better, tell better stories, and empathize better with our audiences. So please do have fun with this process. Go try it at home. But remember, you must lead AI. Don't let AI lead you.